What? Is there a fucking windowed mode? Oh, here we go. This better be good. Everyone beats off and then jizzes their pants about how good it was. So, I don't know. Let's see if it's any good. It is possible that certain scenes in this game are shocking to an unwarned public, or maybe not. Musical pieces created by Elias Conrad Coldwood. Okay. You have been assigned to a being called the Batter. The Batter has an important mission. Be sure that it's accomplished. We will let you out in Zone Zero. Good luck. For more information, find the one called the Judge. To move my body, use the arrow keys. To interact with the environment, use the space bar or enter. I hope there's no random battles in this. It's a nice sound effect. There cannot be any other living beings in Zone Zero, so I must assume that you are only a mere figment of my imagination. Nevertheless, I shall introduce myself. I am the Judge, and I am aching to know your name, dear illusory interlocutor. I am the Batter. I've been assigned to a sacred mission. It is a pleasure. However, it is not the puppet I was addressing, but the puppeteer controlling it. What is your name, dear puppeteer? His name is Vine. He can't talk to us. However, he can hear and see everything. Even though you two are but an inexistent apparition in my eyes, let it be said that I am delighted to meet you as well, dear Vine. I believe we're all in need of your services. Many people are in need of my services, you know. Everybody loves cats. We rub ourselves against their legs and purr in the most insistent manner. They adore that. I'm not talking about that kind of help. I see, but what sort of service could I offer to an ectoplasmic entity? I have a sacred mission to fulfill. I must purify the world. There is no objective more laudable than yours. I accept to serve you as a guide through this area, if it is any help to you. Thanks. So, fourth wall is broken with some grace. A luck ticket has been found. Confess that I find you quite tangible for a phantasmagorical being. Might you, in fact, be a creature of the flesh and blood? I think so, yes. So I have been mistaken from the beginning. You did not even interrupt me in my deluded phantasms. This is relatively bizarre, I must say, for you are the first living being I was given a chance to encounter in this loo. I had, in fact, concluded that Zone Zero was an empty land. Obviously, I was misled. However, there exist other zones, and in those territories, the risk of hostile individuals attacking you in the most violent manner is quite high. Your sacred mission will likely lead you into these lands. Would you like me to teach you the art of violent confrontation? Ah, fuck it, let's do the tutorial. your battle screen. As you can observe, you will find yourself placed at the right hand of the screen. Your opponent, however, in this case, yours truly, will be located on the left. At the beginning of combat, you will be confronted with a choice, right? I made RPG games, an RPG maker.
Got it.
For now, select attack, select batter. Excellent, dear sportive companion. You must consider the fact that batters and enemies levels determine the impact of your assaults. So it is possible that you or your adversaries could avoid the barrage of attacks that you will throw at each other with slyness. On occasion, your cast iron will get you a critical hit, which will cause teeth to fly in heaps. But let us move on if you are willing to. You may have noticed that when you choose attack for the first time, after you selected the batter, a new window opened itself. Attack leads to a soul strike. Competence permits you to use one of your special skills. Objects will grant you use to items. Finally, the opportunity to flee. Oh, okay. So he wants me to use a luck ticket. Impeccable, your mastery of battle borders on brilliancy, my friend. But there is one more thing we have not yet addressed. I am, of course, talking about competences. They are generally, in layman's terms, special moves that can trigger surprising effects. They may induce a resurgence of health points, or may, in and of themselves, be powerful attacks. Nevertheless, know this. Any use of competences leads to the consumption of competence points. CP. So I ask that you use these skills sparingly. Once your CP are completely consumed, it will be impossible to carry out heavy assault. And if you happen to cross swords with a tougher opponent before being able to get some more CP, victory will be uncertain. Try it. Choose competence. Let's use some cheese pizza. Wide angle. An odd-appearing cryptic cat. Now you know not only all about me, but also about the art of combat. Confrontation ends, theoretically. Right, in other words, win battles by killing enemies. Take good care of your health if you want a successful career in purification. I mean, it's written really well, and this is translation too. From now on, you will be ready to crush all your impure obstacles that get in your luminous mission's way. Well, supposing your intelligence is on the same level with your undeniable capability for dealing with bat blows to an innocent cat. Be it as it may, your training has not yet reached its end yet. Let me ask you to follow me if you still want me as your guide. Oh, he went real fucking fast. I didn't even have to talk to him. I solved it all on my own. Is there a problem, my dear pictorial heroes? I am not your janitor. I cannot do everything for you. Nonetheless, I dare to suggest you wage activating certain ones of these strange floating blocks more than one time if required. So come, solve this intriguing puzzle for me and quickly, if you please. I wish to rejoin the ground floor as soon as possible. Just enjoy the game for what it is. You know what I mean? If you're here watching this, let's just enjoy it for what it is and try to figure out why people like it so much. Right, I'm reading the wall. I see one, two, three numbers, and three numbers, yet there's eight blocks. So, right. So here. One. One, two, three, four, five. Maybe you don't need to hit all eight. Okay. Oh, then the sixth block. So one, two, three, four. I see. That makes sense. Then the eighth block. Then the second block, and then the third block. I see. Took me a second. I was just not sure what kind of incongruous terms this game had in mind for me. Finally, after all that exertion, the eagerly awaited recompense makes its entrance to the scene. Okay. Piece of silver flesh has been found. Of course it's silver flesh. 448287C. 448287. Four, four, eight, two, eight, seven. Here is an accessory that is going to be especially helpful on your purifying quest, dear enlightened student and sportive friend. It is a cube hovering in midair, as you have likely noticed. Nevertheless, you will be able to differentiate it from similar ones by the contrast of bad taste it imposes on your view of its clashing color, defying any course, any sensible course of plastic arts. However, do not judge it too quickly, because despite its criticizable appearance, this red cube is of undeniable use. Aside from rendering you the entirety of your health and competence points, it is capable of saving your progress and sending you to the nothingness. The nothingness is a lieu of transition outside of space itself, where you can travel from one point to another at the speed of light. I now invite you to try it out in order to discover locations more populous than this deserted land. Open your wings, my dear companion, and hurry away towards the following zones without hesitation. Your only enemy is the fear that will grab you. Okay. Do not worry, I too travel a lot, though the different zones, through the different zones of the world. We will newly meet one another eventually, without a doubt. And by the way, take this. This is the object of curious name, will be the key that permits you to enter Zone 1. Have I clarified that you can at any time consult your inventory and characteristics by pressing the escape key? This is the world map, maybe? Train 1 is a really useful means of transport to get about Zone 1. I mean, I do like really weird games, like that Sluggish Moors game, for example. I think that's why so many people recommended this for me in particular. Visitor, welcome to the smoke mines. May I know who you are? Are you an inspector? No, I'm the Batter. I've come to exterminate the impure spirits. The Batter? The impure spirits? Are you some sort of prophet? Or perhaps a man of belief? Yeah, something like that. Who sent you? Nobody. I'm being led by Vine. I don't know him. He must be a member of the superior personnel. In any case, that's good. It means our requests have been acknowledged. Here, I'm going to explain your task. You're at the smoke mines of Damien, the southern part of Zone 1. Here we send workers into deep tunnels to unearth metal from the ground, freeing embedded smoke that was trapped in the depths. Thanks to a variety of tools, we are able to put some of it into bottles, which the Queen sends to other zones. The rest of it flows free, forming the air that our lungs inhale and exhale, so we can live. As the first of four elements, it is an important element. Because without smoke, people would have nothing to breathe. You know what's weird? Just as I got here, I lit up a cigarette. Again, I am not condoning smoking. You know, I try not to talk about smoking while I'm live because I know I have a lot of people's attention. Smoking fucking sucks, but I smoke occasionally. One or two a day. So, point is, I just lit one randomly and then now this is happening. It's like, oh, that's interesting. There we are. And so, finally, how do I put this? Where are the impures? Ah, yes, there we go. There are many specters in the mines. They are becoming more and more aggressive. But, in fact, it would be better if you didn't enter the mines because the regulations forbid visitors to access them. So, here's what you're going to do. There's an annex tunnel that nobody ever goes to, but a miner went in there some time ago. He saw something strange, he said, nothing like the usual. So I thought maybe it's the chief of the specters, so there's your task. If you accept, you'll go into the annex tunnel and kill the chief of the specters. Then the specters will disappear and we can work properly again. There we go. Do you have any questions? No. Great. Impeccable. The tunnel is right down there. I'll wait here. Soon I'll be promoted and I'll be supervisor in Alma. I'm anxious for that day to arrive. Well, well, what do we have here? Is that not Vine and his picturesque jumping jack, the Batter? Are you the Spectre's leader? No, no, certainly not. I am only passing through, not unlike the smoke which is being extracted from this pale and metallic place. However, I believe I know where the one you are taking for an ectoplasm can be found. To tell the truth, I am perplexed. I think it is one of those peculiar objects called a spherical add-on. I have very well tried to approach it, or encroach it, rather, but the operation has failed systematically so far. But I'm thinking maybe you, one who does not have a physical order, will succeed in affiliating this spiritual entity to yours. What an exceptionally intriguing phenomenon. I must admit that I remain perplexed by this unexpected metaphysical reaction. Fair enough, since it has decided to accompany you, I know only to advise you to make the best usage possible of it. Got it. The chief of the specters isn't here? Sorry, but I fear I have to respond in the negative. Apart from this add-on, I have not crossed the way of a single soul in this loop. Okay. It's like a party member? Ah, you're back, so you killed the chief of the specters? No, he wasn't there. I like how verbose my main character is. Oh, really? Crap. Well then, I believe I'll have to let you enter through the main gorges then. But the regulations oppose it. Alright, I suppose this is a very special case, as stated in paragraph 5. So, good. Well, the main mines are on the right. There. There are phantoms down there. They keep us from working properly. But now it's break time for me anyways. What are you doing here? Are you the mine inspector? You've come to eliminate the specters, that is good news. The lamps don't always work in the endmost corridors, and since everything looks the same around here, it's easy to get lost. There are phantasms or phantoms in every corridor, be careful, mister. And besides, who has let you enter? Normally, regulations prohibit external visitors. Show yourselves, corrupted children. I am the voice of forgiveness that'll eliminate your calamitous forms. You got what you asked for. Prepare yourselves to suffer my judgment. Listen to this music, it's great. What is going on with the music? I hear like squeaky toys. It's like Caravan Palace music a little bit. Adversaries purified. It's a lot of luck tickets. This add-on is fighting by my side. That's practical. Let us purify the other galleries. Adversaries. One second. He's completely cool with the spirit hoop. A joker has been found. Revives a person. Chronic migraine is one of the attacks. saturated chain has been acquired. I'm working. I'm being productive. As someone who used RPG Maker a number of times, I mean, it's simple, but it's pretty effective. This does, you know, it does what it sets out to do, so I gotta give the game some credit. Creepy, music is cool. So far, I mean, it's pretty good. I mean, we'll see what all the fuss was about. Did you come from the smoke mines? Yes. But there are loads of specters down there. Yes. Are you a specter? No. Then who are you? Have you been sent by the Queen or by Dedan? No. But you still know how to fight the specters. You could destroy them? Yes. Oh, that would be great. We have, specters in our big barns. Barns? Yes. You're at the metal farmstead of Pentel, the eastern part of Zone 1. Our work consists of cutting livestock in two and extracting the metallic boulders that were contained in the cadavers. What? All the poor quality metal is discarded, forming the ground we walk on. The rest gets purified to make tools and other objects with. Some of it is also put into crates and sent to other zones, so they have tools and soil as well, I suppose. As the first of four elements, it is an important element. Because without metal, people would have nothing to walk on. They would sink and drown. And thus we have specters in our large barns. I must purify the mines first. Ah yes, but the barns aren't that big, and it would be nice of you to take care of them fast, because the Queen's inspector is going to arrive at any moment, so could you please take care of the barns first? Alright. Great, thanks a lot. The barns are directly to the right. They aren't that big at all. You'll see, it's going to be done quickly. These balls are clusters of worked metal which are going to be sent to other zones. It's, metallic. You're going to destroy the specters. Hurry up, we're expecting the Queen's inspector at any moment. We have to pay close attention to the nutrition of the animals if we want high quality metal. There are five specters left in the barn. We have to attack its text. I have to kill speech balloons. Thank you. keep spawning. First base has been acquired. Yeah, I'm a Cooney stream this a while, in January, which I was unaware of. I probably, if I knew that, I might not have streamed this or promised to stream it, but it's fine. From what I hear, this game's pretty short anyway. Yes, I spoke to Ima. She said it was no problem. Moving boulder party. Did it. I really shut your trap, you poor moron. Yes. Has he been in there for long? I don't know. Of course you know nothing. Could have guessed. He will eliminate the specters. Why does he think he's capable of destroying those stupid phantoms? Thinks he's better than you? Better than the queen? No, I don't think that. Shut it. I haven't asked you anything. You all think you're smarter than everyone else, but you're all the same. In any case, that's hardly important. The ghosts will erase that prick. You think you won't succeed? Of course not. Nobody here is capable of fighting the phantoms, other than the Queen's officers. If you'd only listen to me more often, you wouldn't be in so much shit. But then who's going to destroy the phantoms? I could have done it, but you don't deserve it. Too bad for you, you'll just have to take care of your problems yourselves. No, please. I'll be leaving now. I'll be returning to Alma. At least the people there are polite. They ain't constantly cutting you off. Please don't. Goodbye. Piss off. No, don't. I command you. Get the fuck out of my way this instant if you want to keep your job. Who was that person? You're alive? Yes. And the specters eradicated. The barn is pure now. That you must be very lucky. Who was that person? That was Daedun. He's the Queen's inspector or supervisor. You mean specter? No, the Queen doesn't employ specters. He can't be one. But he's hostile. I must destroy him. No, don't do that. He's an envoy of the Queen. You'd better go complete your work in the smoke mines, please. Besides, he's in Alma. No one can get there without proper authorization. So, please, return to the smoke mines. Alright. I love how my main character just does not give a shit. We shouldn't have attached the animals. You shouldn't get attached to the animals. Once you are, it's difficult to put your hands inside. I've played Anodyne. I didn't finish it, but I played a bit of it. Oh, hi, half cows. Nice sound effects. As soon as we extract everything from the corpse, we'll slice it up into pieces and eat the meat. Extracting the metal boulders from the cows isn't what I prefer, but if I do my job well, then maybe I'll get transferred to Alma. said in chat to light the or touch the unlit torch. I am going to do that as soon as I can. Well, if I can find it, that is. I just spawned a fish. Why did you open the door? The specters are going to attack us. Go away quickly. Regulations prohibit outside visitors to enter the main galleries. Go away. Three pieces of Belial's meat. Rev, I won't hit you with the butter sock. It wasn't a sock, it was a napkin. I promise. It wasn't a... God damn it. Fits, wear it. Purified. Adversaries, goddamn adversaries. tired. I mean, he is a baseball player. Finishing this in one sitting. Abaddon's meat. Fuck, why am I finding so much meat? Those classic RPG Maker sound effects. The characters are starting to pile up, aren't they? Pardon? What I'm saying is that the average player doesn't need all these complicated and tedious dialogues. There should be more action and fewer questions. Who are you? I am Zachary, the traditional items merchant that's very necessary in every video game. You'll always find myself in places that you're going to visit before you arrive. But enough blether. I'm not one of those protagonists you need to listen to for hours, so let me see the color of your credits. Where did you come from the smoke mines? Ha, that's impossible. Not a single lamp works down there. You can't have faith guides my steps. Faith? My mission is to purify the mines, but it seems that the phantoms here are particularly numerous. The specters. Where am I? You're at the plastic administrations of Shachitara. Sachihara, the northern part of Zone 1. Our work consists of filling in forms. Afterwards, we wrap them up with string and send them to the courier service. D- there, my ship, they ship the packages, and in return we receive parcels full of plastic. There's a lot of liquid plastic that forms lakes and oceans. There's also solid plastic used to make various objects. As the first of four elements, it is an important element. Because without plastic, the world would have no boundaries. People would walk and walk without ever stopping. But you hunt specters, really? Yes, I am purifying the zone. The specters, I know where they come from. They all come from the Postal Service. The Postal Service? That's where we send out the package forms. The problem is that nobody can remember which floor it's found on. Floor 15,540. Zounds, you again, you're decidedly everywhere. One could believe you were following me. Nonetheless, your steps have not deceived you, for you are here in lieu that can certainly use sacred blows from your holy bat. Perhaps you are already aware of this, but it seems that the story housing Postal Service is overrun by ectoplasm. Probably be wise to find the story with the intangible creatures post-haste in order to dispatch them, but could it be that the task is too difficult for your narrow mind? In that case, I may be able to provide you with some advice. Open widely your ears and listen, for I will not repeat this twice, not even in the midst of most pathetic supplication. In one of the four rooms on the ground floor, all the employees seem to be trained to a particular set of instructions. Additionally, if there was a choice to be made, it would prefer the lowercase over the uppercase. what's the difference between, I mean, the people are all saying the same thing here. So that means 10258. Found it. No one. I am the batter. We're the phantoms. I'm very afraid. Help me. What the fuck? Nice face. Wait, maybe his suit is taking control of his brain. Strange. They are 6 feet under, wrapped in hot metal and liquid plastic. No weaknesses. Weighted embrace has been acquired. Flying ghoul with bad intentions, no weaknesses or resistance. I received. Oh, that's nice. Something strange is written on this form. Second verse, there are eight. Silver spears. Whoops. Soul big insect whose mandibles spit meat. That's my kind of enemy. They are four, each one attributed to an element that protect their respective crystals. Is dead. There are but two in a secret zone. Access to the secret lift is forbidden. Did I say secret? I must pass. Really? No, I think that's impossible unless you have a code. For fuck's sake. Well, I don't have the code. Thank you. probably, it's on the pieces of paper. You guys don't need to spoil anything. There are but two in a secret zone, right? Okay, so the last one is two. Now I have to go back and remember the numbers. You really don't need to post answers, guys. It's fine. I'll ask. If I need help, I will ask. Two digits, perhaps. One, second to last, so 142. Eight, 142. I used those items just before a save point. I thought there was for sure going to be some kind of boss in here.
Miserable morons, piss off! This is my zone, you ain't got the right to be here. Get out of my sight, you phantoms of shit! You! It's you, you're the source.
source of all my troubles, the ectoplasm lord who's been eyeing my beloved zone. What do you want? Why have you decided to be a pain in the ass? I've dedicated my whole life to this place. You've got no right to ruin it with your damn ghosts! Shove off! You're mistaken. I am not a phantom. I'm a purifier. I've come to purge the world of these ectoplasmic beings. How dare you respond? And how dare you imagine that I'd put up with this shit? Listen, good, I'll make this simple. Get out of here and take your goddamn specters with you or I'm gonna kill you. Hope that's clear enough for you. If I see you again, you're dead. The tramway can now stop in Alma. I mean, so I didn't actually cleanse the specters. Just kind of spoke to that one guy. Don't have the right to let anyone pass unless they answer some questions. Mars, 2007. See, I don't know what I'm looking for, so there's so many details I wouldn't really even know where to start. Let's just see what questions he has. The second name came from Jerusalem. The Holy Trinity is made up of Notre Dame first appeared on the... How many threes are there in June? One or more of your questions were false. Shit. How many threes were there in June? One, two, three. One, two, three. Four, five, six. 20. One. 21 threes. Notre Dame de Lourdes. You gotta remember a lot of stuff for this one. Oh, it could be different puzzles or different questions. The second came from the third from the Lord, the Holy Trinity. Kevin. Cyrano. Oh, this is... So it's 22 threes. I missed one. It's up there. I see where it is. Test. I don't know what the answer to that one is. Fucking hell. I have to find the details. It's tough because I don't remember exactly what... I don't really understand the questions. Made up of, let's find out, is it made up of roses? Is it made up of winds? I'll let you guys know if I need an answer, don't worry. See, the Holy Trinity is made up of what? What the fuck is this? Mars is made of winds. All right, vents. I see, so that's winds, I guess. So we know that one. We got the 3-1. Trinity is made up of... Then there's another thing. Notre Dame, the... 6. Okay, 6. Second came from winds 6 22 Cyril Kevin. Charles Kevin and Jonas. Cyril, Kevin, and Jonas. Wins. Notre Dame first appeared in the 6th. Still... Okay. Notre Dame 6th. He wrote 22. It's the first question again. Second came from Jerusalem, and it's the only one I don't think I have right. Roses. It says roses here. June is made of roses. Second came from Jerusalem. And the third... Oh! Oh. I understand that now. There we go. You turn the month March upside down, what two-digit number can you read? Seven. Rewarded with combat. Give me 1 second, guys. I'll be right back. I'm here to see Data. Dayden, of course. You're here at the Meat Fountains of Alma, the center of the First Zone. The Meat Fountains. I love this place. Here, meat flows freely, continually filling these immense metal pools you see before you. Our work consists of pouring this meat into bottles before the fountains overflow. The meat is then immediately delivered to all the other zones from Zone 1 on. As the first of four elements, it is an important element. Because without meat, people would have nothing to eat, and they would die of starvation one after another. So I've heard that plastic, meat, and metal are all important. Master Dayton has an office in the center of the fountains, but nobody has ever found it. Generally speaking, Master Dayton seems to only appear when necessary. Well, there. Who are you, anyway? I've come to liberate the world of malignants. Oh, really? Well then, can you liberate me? Sure. Let's purify you. My righteous baseball bat to the face. You got a mouthful of teeth and it needs to be extricated. Oh, it's this guy. Nice face. Whisper in the Darkness, I believe, is what I'm up to. I think the reason I'm really enjoying Lovecraft is because I wasn't forced to read it in school by a shitty professor. Has that happened to anyone else? Like, you're in school, then they force you to read, like, Bradbury or Poe, and you have a shitty professor, and you just associate that material with them. And it kind of ruins the whole thing for you. The fuck? You can barely hear me over the music. Oh. That's weird. Hang on. Now you can hear me. But yeah, that's happened to me a number of times. And I've never had to read Lovecraft in school. I never had any of that stuff. So for me, I enjoyed actually picking it up for the first time and reading it. But let me just tell you guys, seriously, don't let shitty teachers ruin learning for you. Because that is the worst thing that could happen. And it happened to me for a number of things. 1429 38. Jesus, these guys take a lot of damage. Let me write that down. 1429 38. Years later, when I read Poe again, I was more into it than when I was forced to read it. And I didn't mind reading it. I just hated reading so much of it on such a short time frame and having to, you know, write a fucking essay on it. It ruined it. And there's a lot of great literature and anything, just anything, that could get ruined by a shitty professor. So just don't let that happen to you guys. There's no need. Just disassociate good things from shitty professors. Auto attack is nice. The swimming sound is great. Okay, adversaries purified, 80 credits, luck ticket. Good. Well, crap. Oh, okay, I see. Also, someone just said disassociate good games from awful fandoms. Off and Mother are good examples. Possibly. There are some games that I can't get into because the fandom would piss me off too much. And there's some bands that I feel the same way. For example, Tool. I've discussed this on stream a few times. I like the band Tool, but I can't stand some of the fans. It's because they take it like the word of Maynard is the word of Jesus Christ, and it gets me kind of annoyed. And that was what I dealt with in high school, and even in college to some extent. And I like Tool, but I couldn't ever really get past that part, and I never like gave the albums like a full listen. Just Anima and some of Lateralis I like. Never got any further than that. And a few other things I got into from Tool. But in any case, I eventually learned how to disassociate the fans, because I was out of the fandom. People weren't ruining it for me. So, I don't think I have the whole code yet, so never mind. But, yeah. Like, Dark Souls kind of killed Dark Souls. The fandom of Dark Souls kind of killed it. That whole fan base. They made it tough for me to enjoy the game. And, it really did. When I streamed it that one time, I was not good at the game. It was only, like, 2 hours after playing it for the very first time, or maybe a bit more than that, and I was terrible. And the stream, some of the viewers that were like really big fans of Dark Souls were so incredibly like hostile that it just killed it. It killed the whole thing for me. 5, 6. Now, I'm not saying it's a bad game, and I'm like I said, try not to let fandoms kill something for you. Like, if I didn't stream Dark Souls, and I just kind of, you know, played the game, and didn't get involved and try to figure out what all this was, like why people were talking about this game all the fucking time, I probably would have enjoyed it just based on what it was, but because of all of the external things that happen. There we go. There's the other part of the puzzle. It really made it difficult for me to want to give a shit about that game anymore. Sad. But But yeah, it happens with music too. There are annoying Pink Floyd fans, and I love Pink Floyd. But yeah, oh man, did you listen to Run Like Hell Stoned? Yes, when I was 18 I did. And it's good. It's very good, but you don't need to listen to Pink Floyd high to enjoy Pink Floyd. So, and no matter what you do, no matter what thing you like, there will be fans that ruin something for you. And the same goes for, like I said, learning, or TV shows, or anything that you might enjoy. Try to just enjoy the thing for what it is, I feel. Let's see. 4, 9, 8, 2. 6, 5, 9. Clear. What have I accomplished?
What's up, everybody? It's me, Critical.
It's weird because he's like the only one that I can imitate, and I actually like him. I think he's good.
What's up, everybody?
Wait, why am I going this way? What do I think about the Vine Sauce fandom? Honestly, sometimes it's great. Most people are really cool to me. Sometimes it's just really annoying. Lately, the Tumblr tags have been just disgusting. I don't even know what the hell's happening there anymore, so I'm just... You know, and the reason is people are just posting weird, like, shipping and, like, kind of fanfictions, and Jorgel and Vobo, Bonzi Buddy, Rev Sucks. I mean, it's just, like, it's not every time. It's not all the time. But it can get annoying. I wouldn't say it's the most retarded thing I've ever seen. I mean, that's a pretty blunt statement to make. I really don't think it's like that at all. I think a lot of people on my YouTube are fine. A lot of people that email me are completely fine. People on Twitter are fine. I've had no issues with people. I've met people that are really nice. But where did I open the door? I'm trying to look for a door. But yeah, I mean, there are times where I'm just like, what? Mostly the thing that bothers me is the weird shipping and the weird, like, fucking fandoms that kind of revolve around shipping. Sure. Well, I mean, I've seen people that go crazy about a lot of things. I agree, but some people take things too far. And some people, you have to understand, there's a very young audience for a lot of the internet people that make videos, myself included. We have a younger audience at times, and it can get really, you know, some, they take things too far. So, you know, whatever. I mean, it's not something I think about on a daily basis, to be honest. Oh, fuck. Wait, I did it. Somehow I did... Oh, wait. Here we go. I wish you good day, omnipresent comrade. You'll soon be able to admire all the apples and ultramarine landscapes of this area. You seem bewildered by the unique architecture of this place. If that is the case, you should learn to concentrate. In order to not be misled whilst choosing the opportunities offered at each corner of the maze, you'd better remain and ponder a little while longer before crossing one of these next trap doors next time, young drunkard. Is there like any clues here? Right. Wait a minute. I noticed something. Hang on. Like the Lost Woods in Zelda. I get it. See what I have to do here. And just to clarify, anything has people that take it too seriously. Like, I've seen people take this website too seriously. It's like, we're just fucking streaming video games. You know, I'm happy if you enjoy it. I'm happy if you watch all the streams and, you know, the videos and stuff. I'm even okay if you want to make fan creations of some kind. I love that shit. But any fandom, any kind of thing that has any popularity or attention, there's going to be people that take it too far. There's going to be people that, you know, make a life out of it, and that's where things get weird sometimes. But mostly, like 90% of my experiences in the 4.5 almost years that I've been doing this have been really positive. Just that 10%, maybe less, maybe 5%. It's, you know, it's just life. It sucks, but it's just how it goes. Moderation, I find, is an admirable trait. That's true. Big groups do have tons of different types of people. And expecting all those types of people to get along at every moment is kind of insane. Especially when new people come in all the time. It's just so many different types of personalities in one place. It gets crazy. Anyway, enough of that. You, by the Queen's thousand faces, are you crazy or are you completely retarded? What part of I'm going to kill you didn't you understand? I'm here to eliminate you. You're insane. I'm the guardian of Zone 1. You ain't nothing without me. What mental disorder got your blind faith to hide even the slightest bit of evidence from yourself? I'm the one who's going to purify the world. And you're the pest that eats away at this land. Prepare yourself. You'll taste the pain, you sick spirit. I'm going to cut your face to remove that insufferable smile. What's up with his hand? Thank you. home running this motherfucker. Gotta be dead soon. Nope, maybe not. And we're sleeping. Guess we'll go again. Thank you. the Phoenix Downs this time. Adversaries purified, 3,000, blah, 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 and other things. Cancer card received. The battle, level 7 achieved. Is this a joke? I lost? You've been defeated, Daden, guardian of the first zone. This land is now pure. That started badly. Unrelated note, it's been a while since I've seen Pablo around here. Who the fuck is Pablo? Wanted me to go back to zone 1. Oh, the cat's name is Pablo? What the hell happened here? Inspiration has been found. Did I, like, completely sterilize this place? I saved. Wow, look at this guy. Whoa. This little kid takes a lot of fucking hits. So where is everyone and everything? Because it's all gone. This is endgame stuff, run. Oh. So what you're saying is, I shouldn't be here at all. Okay, so I'm not gonna be here anymore then. Let's just take a look at Zone 2 and see what's going on here. Pink Zone. Meat buildings. I'll tell you what, guys. It's getting late. I've been streaming for a while. I'm feeling like it's about time for me to hit the old dusty trail for the night. So why don't we resume off next time? It's pretty cool. Probably finish the game. People are saying it's short, so maybe one or two more streams. But yeah, I guess I can see what the fuss was about to some extent. Just on a very base, what's the words I'm looking for? On first impression, just based on Zone 0 and 1, I can tell that the game is unique. It's an RPG. It's weird. I like Crypt Worlds better so far, but it's hard to beat Crypt Worlds. So, I don't know. We'll see. I'll finish it. I'm intrigued enough to finish the thing. Normally I wouldn't be, but I feel like it did enough stuff right to grab my attention. So, let's see what art we have. Skies of Arcadia. Still haven't done that. I might be able to do that tomorrow. Try to find those last three moonfish and then actually try to finish the fucking game. That's taking a lot longer than I thought it would. Tamagotchi could happen soon as well. But let me throw on some Zelda music so as not to anger the copyright gods. I don't want people to complain that they couldn't listen to the stream, which from what I'm told by Twitch is they're working on, like I said, just eliminating only the music and not 30 minutes of your stream. So when that happens, that'll be cool. Okay. Let's see, what do we have here? From Moss Pawcat, me getting killed by Shadow Vinny, or Vinesnoss, if you will. From Sharts McDickballs, I look like such a lumberjack in this picture. My god, that I don't have a beard that big, but it's still good. Check this shit out. Motherfucking vibrating Stegosaurus. That was from the dinosaur game we played earlier. If you missed it, It was shitty. From Chinnigan, not a Stegosaurus, Stealthosaurus. From Chinnigan, is that me as a dinosaur? Yes, it is. From Goldfish Girl, this is me shooting dinosaurs. Again, I would prefer completed images, but if it's going to be a work in progress, I understand. There's just so many to get through. That's the only reason I ask. But still, I see what you're going for. From Chinnigan, don't worry about... this is Reg. Don't worry about it. How about we... Yeah, memes. That's how you sound. that's me as a dinosaur. Come on, Reg. Wow. Reg, see, you're famous. People know who... they know all about you by now. From Nolan0604, the retard. You suck at life. It's like a Congress tot. Well, it's a retort. You know. That's... It smells like feet, living the dream. Like Skyrim with electric eel throat. This is from Project LG. From Funny Funny Kid. Freemex. Oh, this is the dude that played with us earlier. From Cold Lord. Loud as fuck T-Rex. One would assume T-Rexes were pretty fucking loud anyway. From Sakoto. Churn the man butter. No, Vinny Kun, please. I'm just food. From Sakoto. Sorry, Yoshi, but I have to kill the dinosaurs. From C. What's this? I don't care. I don't know what Reg looks like, but I always imagine this. So, like, a man in a morph suit. A blue man in a morph suit. With rainbows and flowers and sparkles following him around. You know what? Yeah. I don't know what he looks like either, but I'm sure that's as close as you're gonna get it. From Threefolder. It's not what it sounds like, officer, I swear. Vinny uses CP to beat off. Goddamn. From Busket. Here's some off art. It's me, I guess, as the batter. With the cat on my back, fighting the phantasms. That's a really nice piece of art. Jesus. Thank you, Busket. From Chinnigan. From that straight to this. You can see there's many, many different types of talent in this world. From Sakoto, this battle music. I need these instruments. That's exactly what I was thinking. From the Funny Funny Kid again. It's a hell of a name. Funny Funny Kid, new streamer who said that. No. Oh. From Swaglet. Vinny plays off. From Hot Dog Kid 47. Why I seen this a year ago, why copy? So this is just copied art that's not your own. I don't have confirmation. I am removing it. I'm not going to ban, but if more art like that's posted, you know, I'll try to do a cross search. I can't be bothered right now, but don't take other people's art. That's stupid. From C. I come to purify the world. That's, by the way, that's one of our rules on the Buru. Just don't steal art and post it as your own. From Zinkyu, here's, gee, I wonder what kind of bat this is. It's a different kind of bat. From Zinkyu again, I don't know if he made this, but it's an upside down ghost from Off, I suppose. Right, C made this one. Let's see what else I missed. From Donovan, there's Dire Boar playing Yoshi's Island. I like that one, it's good. From Honeybits, Vinny plays Off. I like that style, it's good. You know, I used to play baseball back in the day. I think I hit the ball twice. Oh, I was in fucking fifth grade. I was forced to play baseball. I sucked at it. I didn't even know how the rules went. No one taught me the rules. I was in outfield. You know, it was just like a waste of my time. But years later, I came to appreciate it a bit. And my friends and I would play. And I actually got better like at the game. I do like baseball. I'm not a sports person, but I like to play baseball. It's fun when you're not waiting around. From Nolan 0604, Vine Socks or Vine Butter. Butter Socks. God damn it. From Curry. From C. Nice face, asshole. From Dakota Spine. Not really art, but I'll check it out. Battle against new legion of enemies and conquer, strongest of foes. Conquer brand new puzzles and challenges. Explore and defend your homeworld from impure forces. Mother Negative One, the war against corruption. I get what you did there. From Korokor, Vinny plays off. Some cool art. From Jalote. Your methods are impure. Is that the butter sock? Yes, it is. From Pig Butt Worm. There's another one. From Fish Laser 97. Nice meme. From Scooty. That's me. From Jack MM. Okay, I think my closing image is for me is obvious today. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I had no idea what I was getting myself into. And it turned out to be a little more interesting than I actually expected. So we'll finish off. We'll continue this at some point, and hopefully I'll finish it. So you guys have a great night. Stick around. There could be some more streams. I know Dyer is streaming BioShock Infinite on his own channel, if anyone's interested. And stick around. Enjoy following streams or go to bed. Whatever the case, I bid you all a great night. So long, guys.